If you're in the game now, you started in a closet.
Yeah.
You had to start. Tell me you know what diamond lights are.
Yeah. Yeah, diamond lights.
Yeah, yeah. DLS.
Bricks.
Yeah, yeah.
Find them.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
In garages. I'm like, how do
I? Oh my God.
35 of these 2 months ago. How did I find 10 more? Of
yeah, no. Yeah, so if you don't, catch that, this is what it was, and then you just don't understand where it all started. Everybody.
You were General Hydro or A and B.
Exactly.
You picked
the two. And they like GH because my workers that like to party too much couldn't read the labels because the vision was blurry, but they could tell that there was a pink, a green, and a red.
Yeah.
And I mean, that was some really simple stuff, and it was designed for people. And then for me, I got into doing a lot of work for large. I used to run large diesel operations, and so most of the weed in Humboldt was all diesel driven, and so I would come into these massive diesel operations. No, Humboldt County, straight in Humboldt, up in Blocksburg, Alder Point, Salmon Creek. And so these were all, 200, 300, 400, up to 400 light operations that were black market diesel driven. But I would come in to put in all new operational systems so they could remove workers. Because fundamentally, there was families that ran the projects, and it was always workers that came in that caused problems because you got to hire workers to come in to do leaf and work and water. So I would put in automated systems that would allow these guys to be able to turn valves and flood whole runs. And then I was working on R&D. So right around 96, when computers first really started being used heavily by people, I was able to get hold of a old Pentium 75. And I did took an adult ed class on spreadsheets so I could learn how to use a computer so I could do spreadsheets. Because I had so many black market operations running that I realized that I could start isolating variables. And so I started isolating variables to find how do we get into 2+ pounds of bulbs. At the time, a pound of bulb was astronomical. Well, I was blowing by a deuce because I started finding the combination of factors that let me do it. And then I had the varietals that achieved it. And so all these other operators that were big would say, hey, if you come in, we're going to give you X amount per light if you can get us into these numbers. And I would need my own cultivar base to provide it. So I started providing cultivars to these large diesel operations. And the next thing you know, I'm spending way more time doing nursery operations for all these massive diesel guys because they were the best clients you've ever seen in your life because they were as pro as anybody's ever been, where you had 4 60-day cycles that had to run from as soon as it rained, you turn the diesels on because it could mask the sound of the generator. Even though it was all subterranean and buried and ventilated systems, they were cautious. And so as soon as it rained, you'd have sound cover and fog cover to cover up the waste gas coming out of the jennies and the sound from the jennies. And then as soon as it warmed up and the helicopters came, you chopped it. So you had 4 60-day cycles, and these guys would lay out their calendar, and you could literally deliver the 3,000 cuts to each one of them on that date. There was no deviation. Yeah, camp would show up. And this was when all outdoor wasn't even Humboldt. Humboldt got wiped out outdoor. Then Gallegos, the DA, comes in early 2000s and says, look, 99 is something I'll work with. That's when everybody started pioneering the 14-pound plants. Yeah. So we went from doing indoor work that I was involved in, then I started doing developmental work on cultivars that had the framework to go big enough. So I remember when Blue Dream was only run indoor. I still know the first guy in Humboldt that ran it outdoor, and he came and said, Kev, I got 11 pounds off my weed. And we were like, 11 pounds? And he's like, bro, I got 11 pounds. And so the next year, we're all running Blue Dream. And yeah, we're all running Blue Dream. We don't want to run Blue Dream.